here's a boat form.
So Professor Roz Anderson began her academic career here at the University of Sunderland over 30 years ago and spent all of her professional academic career here working as a researcher in pharmaceutical and medicinal chemistry.
And she asked if I would be interested in helping on the clinical aspects of her then relatively new prodrug for cystinosis.
It's a rare metabolic condition. It's a fault in the cells whereby the cells can't break down a chemical called cystine. Cystine builds up. The build-up of cystine damages internal organs, starting with the kidneys, but also affecting the eyes, muscles, heart, and other organs.
Because the number of patients are very small, the market will also be very small. And so developing a treatment for such a disease is not attractive to the pharmaceutical industry for the obvious reason that profit is going to be quite limited.
Cystinosis patients are fortunate in some respects because they do have a treatment, but that treatment tastes disgusting, smells disgusting, causes nausea and vomiting. They have to take a huge dose because it's mostly metabolized by the body. Most of the dose they take is wasted by metabolism, and it's metabolized to the most smelly compounds you can imagine, so it's really hard for them. I wanted to make prodrugs. The prodrug isn't active until it's activated in the body, and I wanted to make something that had no taste or smell, didn't cause nausea and vomiting, didn't cause ulceration, and crucially isn't metabolized, or not extensively at least. So that means they might be able to have a lower dose, they would exhale and sweat less of these smelly compounds, and more of the active could get to the right place.
So she knew that she had very little time left, and she made sure that everybody, including little me, that we were aware of the path that was being taken and who was going to do what once she was no longer with us. And I think that is something that I'll always remember about her. She accepted her fate in a positive way and made sure that her work would carry on.
What's been achieved so far is we have a drug which we know works well in laboratory models, and we have the funding from the MRC to now take that drug through regulatory preclinical studies, by which I mean studies to make sure it will be safe to give to patients and that we can make it in the right form to give to patients, so that in 2 or 3 years' time, it will be possible to take the drug forward into clinical studies.
The charity has known Professor Anderson and the University of Sunderland for nearly 15 years now. For a small condition like ours, that's really important. We really value that commitment to the cause, because if you don't have that, then you're really starting from scratch each time. So someone that has been involved with the condition and with the community, knows the people in the community so well, is a huge asset to us. It's impossible to quantify.
At the time of her passing, Roz successfully obtained an MRC grant. That funding is allowing for the preclinical trials of the drug candidate that Roz developed here at the university to be taken through the initial stages of clinical trials.
Patients will benefit, and not only the patients, but their families, stroke carers, the people around her, the patients will benefit. She had, I don't know how many people went through her hands. Certainly, just in the sort of 6 years or 7 years that I knew her, it must be hundreds. And they will take with them her attitude on work, her attitude on her subject. Hopefully, out of those people will come the next Roz Andersons.
The university is about learning. And people come here to learn. They come here to study and learn. It's also about learning in terms of research. What do we know about diseases? Can we learn more about them? Will learning more about them help us to design new medicines to help those people with those diseases? Will it identify perhaps cures? And I think it has an enormous impact on